Good morning, everyone. Today's project, as you can see, I'm back to the nursery. And if you remember in one of the last videos, I talked about getting a road in here. So I got all the fabric that I was able to get. I got 600 feet total. First thing I had to do this morning, I just raised the gate up 4 inches because when we put the base in here, it's gonna go up. So I just did that. And I'm not too worried about spillover on the sides here. And this already has some big rock underneath it, so this area isn't too bad. And this one here, I put out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 runs. So this whole area in here, eventually everything's gonna get done. And I'm gonna get a few extra loads, and unfortunately it's gonna have to be done wheelbarrows, but between all those raised beds, we've got to put that as well. But I can load the wheelbarrows with the loader and get it around. So, and once I build this building, I'm gonna start that in a day or so. I'll just spread it all around there, and there's gonna be a covered porch similar to that coming off the front of this. So this will have to be either material or concrete there as well. So driver just called, he's at the quarry, he's picking it up now, should be here soon.
What he was thinking was that he could spread it forward just as well as it would come out going backwards, and as you will see, that isn't the case, which I was pretty sure wouldn't be the case. The reason I wanted him to backspread it was that so he wouldn't mess up the fabric, and there are also some soft spots out there, so he'd be driving over the material and not only packing it down, but then he wouldn't take a chance on getting stuck. So you're gonna see that my idea would have worked better. He's getting out to hook up the chains to limit this, you know, the amount of material coming out when he spreads, and you'll see he limited it to about 2 feet thick, so he didn't even hook up the chains right.
If you could, probably about 4 or 5 feet.
And there goes my fabric that I spent 3 hours the day before putting out.
No. Well, change of plans. Too wet still, so just gonna dump it. I'll have to spread it out.
I didn't catch on tape was right before this, when he tried to move forward, he got stuck on that side and sunk so far down that he almost tipped over. He had to drop the bed down quick before he tipped.
Yeah, I wouldn't go farther than that.
Yeah.
it's going to be a little spreading action here.
After this load, I had to leave, and he knew what had to go where, and I told him where to put the extra piles, and we shall see what it looks like when I get back tomorrow.
Well, here's Saturday morning. I just got to the nursery yesterday. As I told you, I had to leave around 11, and I told this guy what I wanted done. Well, I knew he didn't know how to spread, but I really didn't know he didn't know how to spread. I mean, this is horrible. He stopped. I mean, there's still like a 100 feet here where he couldn't spread. I wanted him to back spread it, not forward spread it, and he couldn't do it, so he kind of messed up the fabric, as you saw. But I got to do all the way from here, and look at the mountain. It's 150 tons is what we got finally delivered. But I mean, unevenly thick here. I mean, it's about 2 feet thick right there, and that was one of his first dumps when he tried to spread it and dumped half of it out. He had the chains set way too far, and so we got, what do we got, five loads. One, I mean, I can't even get over to that one until I move these. I wasn't planning on moving anything over into this area yet, so oh boy, this is what happens when I'm not there. So, and I got to go to the lumber yard right now to go grab the sill material so I can put the sills down on that slab tomorrow, and they close at noon. So there's a little look at what I got to do. So I better get to it and stop talking. the end, I got pretty much all that spread. Still got to be finished graded off, but I'm going to do that at the end after I, with my trucks and trailers and the concrete truck comes in, it's going to pack it down. So it's not finished graded and still going to need a little bit more material to get in between the beds and around the building. But at least now I can get in here and work and I won't sink and I can set up the tools. So I'm going to do the, put the plates, sill plates, and get the wall plates laid out, and Monday I'm going to start framing this and I'll finish rough grading around there with the rake. But that's a look. It's about 3 o'clock right now. I started at, I think it was about 10. So that's another one.